You're listening to Potty Mouth Radio, the home of movies, music, television, and comedy.
Previously on Time to Die. The pit. We put a statue into the pit. Thelonious got over the pit. Then we all looked at the pit. The pit. I got stuck in the pit. Kalana got over the pit. But I was stuck in the pit. The pit. I was stuck in the pit. Felomir got over the pit. But I was stuck in the pit. Oh, the pit. It was 8 foot wide, the pit. I could have just jumped over it, but I got stuck in the pit.
I'm Paul, and I'm playing Kalana, a stunningly beautiful female high elf who is also a rogue.
I'm Liz, and I'm playing Umlaut, a young half-orc fighter from the Nibblefeet tribe.
I'm Dave. And I'm playing Felomir Wolfborn, a half-elf wild magic sorcerer.
I'm Billy, and I'm playing as Thelonious the Monk. Get it? A 9-foot-tall, 500-pound tiefling who until recently had never left the monastery.
I'm Drew, and I'm your dungeon master.
It's time to die.
Bill? It is now Erky Timbers' turn. Erky is not sure exactly what to do. There's a lot of commotion happening. Erky is going to try and he's going to run across. But he's going to move 5 and he's going to run. He's going to jump and he's going to land right there.
God, Erky Timbers is at least as strong, if not stronger than I am.
This is just crushing Umlaut's soul. She's like, what have I come?
We are idiots, guys. Spent all this time on dragon statues. We could have just
Umlaut
jumped.
Makes a solemn Erky's promise to herself right now. She's like, you are going to do Pilates and yoga every morning when you wake up. From now on, you've got to do it.
All right. Erky is going to move out of the way because he knows that everyone is, you know, trying to get in here. But with moving out of the way, the creature is going to get an attack.
On me?
On Erky because he moved out of the way. And he missed because apparently I can't roll worth shit for him. All right.
So, which we're all very pleased by, do you think?
Yeah.
Everyone's okay. All right, Thelonious.
Okay, so the creature has taken 5 damage, but we don't know how much damage it has. All right, I'm gonna
you've dealt 5 damage.
All right, I'm gonna swing my mace.
Okay,
16. Do I hit?
Yeah, you hit.
Excellent, and I do 3 bludgeoning damage.
It all counts, Billy.
Well. Thelonious has gone. Right.
Okay.
You're up.
So Umlaut can't climb her way out of this pit, can she? Because it's 10 feet and she's like 6 feet.
Well, can't you climb up the statue, though?
You could climb up the statue.
And try it again, right?
Well, I mean, once you get on the statue, you can just...
climb out of it. Okay,
what I will do. It's just like an incline. Yeah.
That's what I'll do then, please.
Okay.
Do I need to roll something?
Sure. No, you can just make your way up the statue, and you'd have to probably, I just realized I'm moving a statue, you'd probably have to move to here, which is at the very edge next to Thelonious.
Yep, no worries. I would do that. Do I still have an attack availability? Like, was that just movement, or?
Yeah, I'll give you an attack. I mean, we'll say like Yay. That the movement to climb up and then, you know.
Yeah, cool.
Get a crew.
All right, sure. So yes, I will.
Oh, thank God.
All right, girl.
You've got to help here. This is ridiculous. And then, like, I talk myself into climbing up the statue. I get up to stand next to the Thelonious. I'm like, don't worry, I've got this. And then I'm like, get out of the way. And then I swing my great axe at this.
Lots of talking.
Thing. Well, I'm talking as I'm doing, I think. And so now I will attack with my great axe. There you go. So 13. I roll 13 to hit with my great axe.
And a 13 hits.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Ooh.
Okay. Yay. So then I'm going to do 1d12 plus 3 damage. So let me roll for that. What did I say? D12. So I do 10, I think, bludgeoning damage. No, slashing damage.
As your axe kind of like leaves into the creature, a little bit of blood like falls out of its, you know, right side, and it falls to the ground, and it looks at all of you and it says,
You've broken my bond. You've broken my bond.
And then suddenly it flies up, changes into a bat.
This seems fine.
And then it... And then it flies away.
Okay.
Sure.
So was that thing the fucking statue that was missing or not?
Oh, I hadn't thought of that. I mean, I would guess it was some kind of guardian. Well,
something walked out
room.
Of that alcove on Small's clawed feet.
Guys,
went
that's
into
cooked.
The pit. Came out the other side, presumably.
Okay.
Well done, team. Right.
Well,
that
maybe,
is a
well.
Big win.
And
against the scariest thing other than the dragon we've seen so far.
We freed
no
a bat.
No one got poisoned and we freed a bat.
I don't know if it's a bat. I don't think it's a bat.
No.
Bats don't talk.
I reckon it's a vampire. All right. While we're over here, like, we haven't actually looked around this room. I see from the map there's like a statue of a dragon again.
We don't
really
have a map.
Dragon statues.
That's
no, we don't have a map.
Player knowledge, not character knowledge.
So in this room itself, violet marble tiles cover the floor and the wall. Though all are cracked or broken, revealing a rough-hewn stone beneath, the room is illuminated by a pallid green flame burning from a single torch. A marble sarcophagus, easily 9 feet long, lies in the room's center. The coffin's lid is carved with elaborate dragon imagery, and the head of the sarcophagus resembles a dragon's head, and rusted iron clamps firmly lock down the lid.
Guys, I'm right. It was a dragon vampire.
Yeah, how do you combine that? What's the what's
it was
the
a dragpire.
A draper? A vem? A vemgen? A vamp drag? What about a vamp drag?
More importantly, Thelonious, don't open the sarcophagus.
Oh, well, I was thinking please. About it. I mean,
I know
we're effectively trapped here, right? Are there any doors in this room? Because
well,
how do we?
Umlaut loves to open doors, and the sarcophagus lid could
investigate
be considered
the room
a
to
door.
The north.
Yeah, can we see any doors or
level
openings, Drew?
One. Can I just remind you?
Level one.
I'm like, you go.
You do not see any doors.
Shit.
I'm like, walk straight to the green flame and is like, this looks pretty. What can we do with this?
It's a single torch in a sconce and it is glowing a green flame.
Is that the thing that looks like a crab?
Yeah.
Or more like a koosh ball.
I mean, it's obviously right. Not just a normal flame.
Can I check for traps on this sarcophagus?
Sure.
Can I take the torch out of the sconce and so I can like walk around with it?
You can.
Cool. Semi-shiny green stick.
You're now walking around with a green torch. So with your perception... You don't really find any traps. You can
hey,
do Valamere, an investigation.
Do you want to look for some magic for around this thing? Do we?
I'm wondering. I'm just going to throw this out there. The carved dragon head on the tomb. Is its mouth open or anything? Like, is there a chance for us to like light
Sticky
a little
handed.
Green fire inside of its mouth or something?
Backing away.
Oh, Umlaut walks over with the torch and says, shall I shove this torch in the dragon's mouth?
That's what I'm wondering.
What is that what you want to do?
Is there
I was
an
about
open
to
mouth?
Come over and enter the room, but I think I'll wait here.
Is there an open mouth, Drew?
Whatever's in that is definitely friendly.
I think Umlaut's going to walk over to it and just say quite loudly, excuse me, Mr. Drag Vamp. Person in the tomb, are you gonna kill us? And just like then like
put her ear, but not touch, but like her ear right up to see if she hears anything.
You can give me a perception check to see if you hear anything.
Ooh, that doesn't sound good.
I was expecting an immediate nothing happens and you're an idiot, so...
No, you're not an idiot.
Well...
Let's wait until you... Yeah, okay, you find nothing.
I almost want to burn my inspiration just so I can roll a high perception check. But I'm not going to. So I know nothing, and I'm like, they didn't answer back, guys, so I guess there's nobody in there. Where else can we go?
I feel like we have to do something with this green flame. Try bring it close to the dragon's mouth or something.
I hand you the green flame and I say, please be my guest.
All right. As a man of God, I take the green flame and I kind of shake it towards the dragon head. Yeah, just all over it. Nostrils, mouth. I'm just like, eat it.
Eat it.
The more you shake the flame, just green light. It's almost like a rave now. It's just kind of like going around the room a little bit.
Yeah, I'm not dancing in a head to sandstorm.
You also find out that no matter how hard you shake,
it doesn't go out.
Flame, it doesn't seem to go out.
Yeah, that's what I figured. This flame is obviously a magic flame because no one has been tending to it or keeping it lit, as far as we know. Like,
can we get the magic man to do a magic check of magic on the magic flame?
Yeah, can I use my 8 strength to jump across now?
Oh, I didn't realize you weren't in the room.
I was going and then the Thelonious started investigating things, and that never works out well.
We'll just move folks so you can get across.
All right. Sure. I'll investigate this thing in case anything wasn't picked up by the...
Is that an arcana check, or...?
I mean, are you're checking the torch?
Oh, I'll check the torch first. That seems safer.
Or were you checking the sarcophagus?
I'll check the torch first.
Okay. You can just give me an arcana check. Yeah, sure. With an 11, you just know it's a continual flame.
guys. The dark forces that I have access to have informed me that this is a continual flame.
Continual flame, an ever-burning torch. However you want to refer
I'm
to it.
Roll. I'll check out the sarcophagus as well.
Sure. Do you want to give me perception, investigation? What would you like to roll?
Perception, I get a 1, so that's better than investigation. I'll do that. I'll do perception.
Okay. All right. Wow. Go from an 11 arcana to a 12 perception. Investigating, that's fine. Investigating the sarcophagus a little bit further, it reveals that there are inscriptions and art, you know, along the sarcophagus itself, and detailing elaborate draconic calligraphy.
Ooh, I shall read that quietly in my head.
That's fine. So,
can I peer over him and I'll read it? I'll read it in my head as well.
I put my hand like he's trying to cheat in class.
Evidence that men can learn from their mistakes, everyone.
I didn't make mistakes. I learned from his mistakes.
All right, so elaborate draconic calligraphy is etched into the surface of the marble of the sarcophagus lid beneath a large mural. The mural itself depicts 3 distinct images that together tell a story. On the left, priests are holding chains and they enter a cavernous room. At the center of the room, a troll stands above the corpse of a dead dragon priest. And on the right, a massive red dragon stands with its back turned to the troll and the dead dragon priest. And then you can read in Draconic, tasked with returning the red god's life, he sought to harness the power of life for himself. For that, he is punished.
This screams lich. This screams undead, nasty, wizard, mage thing in this sarcophagus. And level 1 characters who have just come out of the monastery probably aren't going to do well here. I feel like we've gone to this side quest thing, which we were never meant to find.
I know, but okay.
I don't know. Well, Umlaut loves the pictures. She's very taken with the pictures.
What do we want to do? Do we want to walk away at this point and just go back out and see what Calcrix is doing?
makes a really boring episode if we just walk away.
I know.
We'll probably edit this part.
I'm trying to wait for something that gives us a good like end.
I'm waiting for the DM to give us a very subtle hint. The lid.
No, I'm joking. There was a joke. I didn't do that.
Yeah, can you give us a hint, Drew? That I'll edit.
Drew's
out?
Giving what us about as much as those four statues that are still in the alcoves.
Liz said what?
No. Nope.
Liz didn't say anything.
Something about the lid?
Nope. What was it?
Drew said, if you say it, it happens.
Because like, I can.
Oh, in that case, I just became level 26.
I got a very fun rule. Are you
we all leave
it
the
happens.
Room and leave the level 26 self.
Drew, can you give us a subtle hint of some kind as to what we should do here?
Thelonious prays to his god for guidance.
Well, so... I mean, okay, that's fine. You want to pray? Give me a religion check.
Oh, yes. Omelette will pull out her little cord. like her little cord figurine and be like...
Yeah, Omelette prays to her pet rock.
All right. I'm okay, no, that's good. Actually, yeah. All right.
I'm like, yeah, Thelonious, let us pray. Oh. And I think I should push you down on your knees and we'll both sit there and then I'll pull out my figurine.
How does the monk who's never left the monastery until 3 days ago fail at religion?
Okay.
I did better than Omelette, though, with a four.
Yeah. Omelette, she's a tutu wearing fighter. That's not her job.
So all you hear in your head is the voice of your master at the monastery constantly yelling and bickering at you because you could never remember to put the lid on right when putting away the food. And rice would go poor. And the milk would spoil.
Wow, you're really dumb.
That's all right.
Pretty basic.
Well,
how do you solve a problem like Thelonious?
All right, I'm going to do some perception and have a look at the hinges and stuff on the lid of this sarcophagus.
When in doubt, roll something else.
All right, well, with your perception check, you are able to notice that along the lid of the sarcophagus, there are rusted iron latches that are holding it down rather firmly.
And are these latches able to be unlatched?
Before we do that, do we think, based on the story that we have read on the lid, which I did recount to you because I'm kind and nice, and they were pictograms anyway, so everyone understood them, do we think that this sarcophagus holds the nasty troll thing or... It's too small for the red dragon.
Well, we don't know how deep it is.
Whatever's in here, people did not want it to get out, and I'm assuming it's the thing that was punished.
Correct.
For rather than freeing the red god for trying to steal its power to prolong its horrible lichy life.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, what is the benefit in letting it out?
For clarity, was there any...
For fun.
Was there any doors? Like, there wasn't any doors, right?
There's no doors. We're trapped here.
I'm
not going to just turn to you and be like,
we haven't tried to go back over and say stars by the original door.
True.
Well, Amlad is going to say, well, I think that, you know, I like doors and maybe this lid is like a door. And maybe actually in the sarcophagus, there's not a person at all, but there's like a stairs.
That's exactly what I thought. I was wondering if there's stairs to get down.
So why would it be bolted, chained, and put in a sealed room on the other side of a pit full of spikes?
Because to keep the stairs go to somewhere scary.
This little demon thing, creature, whatever it was like, you've severed my link! In my best Drew impersonation.
Bond.
So do you think that guy was actually there like to protect this sarcophagus? I didn't even think of that.
Amnat wants to reach over and take the staff back with like the green flame from Thelonious. I'm like, can I have my pretty green shiny back, please?
All right. I hand it to her and I
am melting into the shadows, which is going to become a thing. I'm hiding in the shadows, keeping very... So if something pops out, okay. I am going to wait while it attacks
Kalana,
all of you and stab it.
What do you reckon these guys'
chance
of survival is? I'm in the corner away from
the
action.
Well, I'm going to take Kalana doing that as a sign that she's waiting for me to open the lid of this thing.
Don't stand near me. Don't give away my position.
And I'm going to do it. I hand the flame to Omelette.
Find your own hiding spot.
I was here first.
I hand the flame to Omelette and I open the lid of the sarcophagus.
And I shine the torch there.
Well, there's six rusted iron latches. You're going to have to go for each latch.
Yeah, I undo two at a time with my hands.
Yeah, you can give me a strength check to try.
When I see him doing that, I say, here, take this to Erky, and I give him the torch, and then I'm going to help.
Right.
And so I can
pray
also...
Pray to your god, Erky. Is this
I'll
a good idea?
I'll try a couple more.
Erky will pray.
All right, I rolled a 10 for strength. I'm guessing I can't do anything.
A 10 does not do it.
I got plus 3. So I got 11.
No.
Okay.
Oh, well.
I turn to Thelonious and I'm like...
I roll 3 times and I get a 15. I keep trying. I keep going at it.
And your effort pays off. You break off one of the latches.
Inspired by him, I try myself to roll again. And I to see if I can try again, and I get a 12 this time.
Doesn't seem to do it.
Okay, I'm like, damn it, I'm stronger than this stupid
man. Okay, and all right, and now that like one
and
latch
then I get a
open,
20 non-natural.
Nothing has happened, right?
So, Liz, you break off another latch. Mm-hmm. There are
30% of the way towards total player death. Woohoo!
There are four left.
We look at each other and we're like, we'll just keep trying?
Well, have we broken...
Do we hear the ominous hum of magic building?
So there are six, and I'm guessing that we've broken two. So are there three on each side, or...?
Yeah, essentially, yeah, you can just say there's three on each side.
I think we've broken two on
the
same
side.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if we break off one more on this side, then we might be able to just, like, lift. So I get a 16.
You break off a third one.
All right.
And then
understand, like, they're holding it down. It's not like a hinge.
Yeah, but...
Like, they're holding it down.
But we couldn't...
You need to break them all before you can open it.
I don't feel like you do need to. I feel like you'd be able to...
I can't.
You don't understand how boxes work. You've just come out of the monastery.
okay, I broke another one. I just got a... Oh, wait, no, yes. I got another non-natural 20.
You have four.
I mean, I feel like we're meant to do something with this flame, right?
So we've got four out of
17.
Six.
You have five.
Okay. All right,
you do the last one on blood. At this point, I'm going to back away, and I'm just going to stand over here while you do the last one.
And that's getting more and more frustrating.
You've started this ball rolling down the hill, and now you're just going to stand away and
finally
let it roll.
Finally gets a 19 and goes, there, as the last one snaps off, right?
All right. As soon as it's broken, does the lid just fly off as a monster comes out?
I am free.
You have broken off all six latches. There's the sarcophagus.
Oh, Polonius, we have to lift the lid ourselves. God, there's so much effort.
All right, I'll grab one side, you grab the other, okay, babe?
Yep, sounds great. What
is the lid heavy? Do we need to roll
strength?
Have
you forgotten who I was?
Oh, both of you need to give me a strength check.
Okay.
Oh, a strength check for a change. I got an 18.
Okay.
I got a 16.
Together you are able to lift off the lid. Where would you like to place the lid?
On top of
Kalana. Now that we're a party of two, what should we do?
I think, do we just put the lid down on the ground next to it?
Yeah, I would say we just lift it and put it on the side, flat on the ground.
Yeah, yep.
Maybe just shove it slightly over so you can see what's in, but too late, you've said it.
Yeah, too late.
We're not the thinkers. That's why the thinkers should be standing there telling us what to do.
No. The thinkers are standing in little alcoves in the dark where they can't be seen.
Well, that's the giant, terrifying monster.
Inside.
It's the ogre that I said was in there.
Inside is a troll dressed in rotting finery, but its jewelry and rings adorned with tiny silver dragons sparkle. The creature's body is shrunken and elongated, and its flesh is a rubbery, putrid green. Its black hair is long and thick and ropey, and its beady eyes flash open, and it snarls. Everyone can roll for initiative.
Can I yell?
Even the ones that are carefully hiding in the shadows?
Next time on Time to Die.
Yeah, but we can't use them on people who are...
Yeah, I need to be conscious to take it.
Apparently we can't put a funnel
apparently,
in his mouth. And...
Apparently I was wrong about that. I thought I was very right, but apparently you can shove a potion down someone's throat.
I had played it like that before, but I was like, oh, this is just this DM's rule, so that's
I think, to be safe, we'll use it like a suppository.
I don't see how going anywhere near Thelonious's ass is safe, so...
Thanks for listening to Time to Die. If you want to get in touch with us, you can do that at pottymouthradio.com or pottymouthradio@gmail.com or on all the socials at pottymouthradio.